It's been a long time since I blogged. I start every blog with, it's been a long time since I blogged, because it's been a long time since I blogged. It's been even longer for Mrs. Clay. Now, Mrs. Clay was the person who came out. She had the red t-shirt and the blue apron and did the air dry projects, the kids projects aimed at children, and the three rules, and wet and wiggle and twist and stick. And Mrs. Clay hasn't been around for a long time. I think she's moved away to somewhere very warm and sunny. Since it's minus 27 C this morning, Mrs. Clay's a very smart lady. But anyway, I don't know if she's coming back. For those people who followed Mrs. Clay and the air dry methods, just watch everything that she put up there. And all the information is there. If you're directing kids' workshops, just show them what's there and let them go play. Trust me, kids know how to play. Just let it go. And who knows, maybe she'll come back from the beach one day and maybe she won't, but she's not coming back today. Anyway, what did I do? Last year, it's been a year since I have blogged. So what did I do last year? Last year was a busy year for Jim and I, and Jim's here today. I tried the blogging by myself, and we all know how that went. It's been about a year since I blogged, and it was a busy year for us. Last year, I quit teaching. I've been teaching on and off since I was 18 years old, which is, I turned 39 again and again. And it's been a long time since I've been teaching. And also when I was teaching here, we had a Tuesday night drop-in class, and it worked really well. There were 6 to 12 ladies who would come, who would drop in as their schedule come, and they would work on whatever they wanted to work on. We'd work on throwing and sculpture and whatever direction they wanted to go. But these ladies came for a few years and became quite prolific. And they basically took over my studio. As nice as they are, I ended up putting all my work on tables in the hallway because they are in here. And I woke up one morning and I just said, everybody's out, and I'm enjoying having all my stuff on my shelf. So I quit teaching last year and I made lots of pots. Good question is, how many is lots of pots? Lots of pots is just more than you want to make. And I made lots. So I made lots of pots for the summer market, and then we put on a couple trade shows a year. We did our first annual Coots Days Outdoor Market, which started off gangbusters until the torrential rains hit and we ran like cockroaches off the ship, and we'll try it again this year. So I got that done, and then June we had company. And we had some company, and then we had some company. And it was nice. I love, anybody watching this, I love to have you come back and see me again. And then July came, and Jim and I built an addition on the house. When I say Jim and I built an addition on the house, we built the addition on the house. It started off as a little 8x8 entry room. It's a long story. Now, Jim and I have done before. We bought a fixer-upper, and we've replaced everything in our house with the exception of the bathtubs, and we cut out holes in the wall and made an outdoor entryway. And so we're not without some skills, but when he talked about building an addition on the house, I thought, I can't build an addition on a house. I can't build a whole building. But I thought, well, I don't want to tell him because he's so sure that I can. And so, sure, we'll see how it goes. And then Jim started talking about building the addition on the house. And he started thinking, I can't build a whole house because, I mean, well, I'm going to look for him for direction. He's never built a whole house before. Well, it's not a whole house. It's a 16 by 16. And so, but he said, Cindy's so sure that we can do it. I don't want to say anything. So you know what? We built the building. And we did. We didn't pour the cement, but after the cement was poured, we built the foundation, we built walls, we stood them up, we carried 4x8 sheeting at ladders. I got over my fear of scaffolding. I stood on scaffolds with a nail gun and hammered the sheeting at the top of the peak. It was great. And we did it. So, but it took us a while. We got to the end of September and we're kind of finished. Well, we're not finished. It needs drywall and paint, but I learned last year that drywall and paint is just decorative. We'll get it done this year. So then we got the house built. Then it was time to make pots again. So I put my head down and we made lots of pots for the Christmas season. But one interesting thing happened to Jim last year is he became mayor. He's now the man. People call him his worship, which is weird. I don't call him his worship. Warship, perhaps. But he is his worship, Mayor Willett, now. That's not odd. So he's the mayor, and so we made pots, and we put on another trade show. We put on our Coots Christmas Market. And we don't, they're not a great big 100 vendor trade show. These are a little 35 vendor trade show, but we put them on and we do it for the community, and everything raised goes back in the community. And now that he's his worship, it's a good thing. So we did that. And then at the end of the year, so that's my whole year in a nutshell. We'll do pecans because they're nicer than walnuts. It's my whole year in a nutshell. And usually what happens in January and February is I play. And I do little funny dragons and I do funny people and I like to play. We've had the Sally and Martha chat before. But this year I went to work. Because when I was doing the budget for our 16 by 16 edition, Sally did the budget, and she was pathologically optimistic with the budget. So this year I'm making mugs, lots of mugs. Again, there's more than you want to make. Mugs and little trays that sell. And I'll work this year and I'll play next year. I did make these little bottles the other day. But work and play and all that stuff is another whole video, and I've hammered on long enough. So what's going to happen in the studio today is I'm going to wrap up this little order for a store in Milk River, Alberta called Smart Alice. Now I know who owns the store, and her name is Debbie, but she's very smart. So I'm going to wrap this up. I'm going to put these pots in the kiln and get them out of the way. I'm not going to fire the kiln. They're just going to go in there and wait. I was going to just throw a couple of pieces today, but I have a customer. He's been our customer for 20 years, bless his heart. And I asked him to order, because all this stuff is out of here in about 3 weeks or 2 weeks, and I want all of this gone and start over again. And so I wanted all of that thrown and going with these pots here. But I got an order late last night in the internet, and he ordered mugs. And you're thinking, you've got mugs, but he didn't order any mugs like this. He ordered different mugs. So I'm going to make Dina's mugs. I'll throw a few more pots. Jim's going to take some video of me throwing some pots and some beer mugs. And if I ever quit talking and then I get these pots in the kiln and I get my clay ready and I throw my mugs and I finish talking and being filmed by his worship, it's going to be a day. Want to do it again?
No.
Really?
Happy with it.
It's fine.